Hello everybody, my name is Sam K, and welcome back to Mafia 2. So we're gonna be doing Home Sweet Home this time. Let's continue the cutscene.
A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
There it is. Empire Bay.
All right, and we are back in the action. We are talking to our friend Joe, who you remember from the first cutscene.
He's better than a foxhole.
So I'll let you guys listen to this.
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's going to keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though. A drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito. Come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes. We're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal. What was it like over there anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading?
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calo.
No shit. Don Calo. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here. Wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the U.S. of A. and to having you back home.
Salud.
A salud. Chin down. So how come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
Nah, I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait. You mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't wanna go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Both mother and daughter working for the Yankee dollar.
Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know, the guy's name is Vito Scaletta. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later.
The situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl.
Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Como no frade, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you wanna ride?
No, thanks. I wanna walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
All right, so we are going to be walking around for a second.
Here we are.
All right, thanks. Keep the change.
Oh, boy. Here we go. This is where I have to turn this kind of crap down.
And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
It's still playing the fucking music,
and
dude.
Doesn't show signs of stopping. And I've brought me some corn for popping.
It's just one lousy beer.
Well, I'll take the copyright hit, guys. I prom. I'll take it this time. It is winter and stuff, so I'll take the copyright claim this time.
Hold me tight. All the way home I'll be warm. And the fire
what,
is
lonely?
And my dear was still goodbye. But as long
but just look how good, beautiful this game is, though. It's 5 years old, and it's still, like, kicking ass in the graphics department. Like, look at the clothing. There's wrinkles, and there's movement. This was, back during 2010, this was literally the best looking... Oh, shit. This was literally the best looking open world game at the time. So yeah, it was really, really well done by 2K and whatnot. Alright. It's time to go see Mama. Well, hello to you too. Okay then. I think that cat committed suicide, but... Alright.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito, my boy. My boy's home.
Hello, Mama.
I see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
Oh. Sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Soup.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Vito, you know better. Non c'era che fatta volontà. Stanno ricevendo provvedere a quello che ci metti in mano. Per Cristo nostro Signore.
Amen. You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
Oh boy. Yeah, apparently Vito and his family are religious. I don't know if that's a applies to Italians or what. I don't know. If you're Italian, let me know, because I don't know. Because, you know, I'm American. So just let me know if it's, like, common for people to be religious if they're Italian.
So how you two been? Franny, what have you been up to?
I still live here with Mama. I got a nice office job. It pays the bills, and I started paying off some of Papa's debts.
Francesca, we don't want to talk about that now.
Yeah, whenever their father died, he left them with a lot of debt, which sucks.
How are you, mio bambino? It must have been so terrible. I was so afraid. I prayed for you every day.
I'm okay, Ma. I drove a Jeep most of the time. Sometimes I had a fight.
I drove a Jeep most of the time. What's a Jeep? Oh, man. Wow. She really did leave it just the same. Yeah, that's weird with the door animation. It looks good if you're positioned right, but it looks strange. Turn off the light. Can I shut these blinds? I don't remember if I can. Alright, let's just go to sleep then.
I'll see you 2 in the morning.
Sleep well, mio bambino.
I love how he just says it. Just like... I'll see you two in the morning. Just in his normal voice, not even to, like, raising it a little bit so they can
hear
him.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
You mean I can't walk outside in my boxers and undershirt? How dare thee? How dare thee tell me what I can and cannot do? Okay, let's do that. Looking pretty swaggy, pretty swank.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Papalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him. Work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
I feel so bad for his mother because she just wants him to do the right thing and lead a good life, you know? Okay. You can wash your hands in here, I think. Or at least you can turn on the faucet. Yeah. And you can flush the toilet. Then make sure you shut the door because you're a good gentleman. There we go. Didn't want to talk to you either.
I don't give
a damn. I'm
sorry. I don't
we'll
care if you
money.
Gotta sell
hey.
Everything
I promise.
You got.
What the
what
fuck?
What the hell's going on here?
You messing with my sis?
You mind your business, asshole.
No.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. Don't use that finger on me.
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on. Show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse.
Come on, bud. You want some? You want some of this shit? Oh, son.
Stop, stop, please.
Oh. Ow. Fuck you. Oh, fuck you.
Please, Vito, this isn't your problem.
Fuck off. Teach this idiot a lesson.
You'll get yourself into more trouble, Vito.
Boom! Fuck out of here.
Ah, fuck this. Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here. You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing back is then, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
He was talking in his head there, guys, in case you didn't know. But anyway, so $2,000 back then is like our equivalent of like $200,000 or maybe even more than that. You almost hit me, fucking jack off. Okay, I need to steal a car, make sure no police are around. Okay. Wait, I can't steal the car, seriously. Okay. Guess I'm not stealing a car. Yep.
Hey,
looks like my ass is walking.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
Oh. My bad.
Hey, this is bad.
We ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
Picked up these broads on my way back from the store.
Oh, God.
All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. We have to stop and we can all have fun.
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. You know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
All right.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
No, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's Ooh. Gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I did was make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
Doop-a-doop. Are we walking there? Watch this, this is cool.
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, you but know. This ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
What the hell's a Jeep?
Never mind. You gonna let me drive or what?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful.
Just be
right,
fucking
careful.
All right,
when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
Whee! I'm gonna crash into everything
now.
Make
a right here, then just go straight for a while.
Yeah, the roads being icy actually does affect
Slow
the car,
it
believe it or
bit.
Not.
No need to get pulled over for no reason. Hey, Vito. You know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Damn it, Vito.
Oops.
What the hell are you doing?
Sorry, Joe. Won't happen again.
Oops. Oh, man. I have too much fun with this shit.
You know, you really wasn't too bad behind the wheel. You could still use a little practice, though.
I fucked up his bumper.
Get a load of that baby.
Nice. That's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's.
Oh, shit. I forgot that they don't jack the car. They go to Giuseppe's, then they jack the car.
You name it, he's
I thought it was the other way around for a second.
Gun permits and discharge
like I said, it's been a while.
Guys tired of getting their asses shot off. Hey, Giuseppe, I brought
Hello,
you a
Joe.
New customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
retired,
Bay.
Please. How are you? The papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army will bother you again, trust me.
You see? What I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
Take
the
papers?
We need some lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Me. Oops. So used to pressing escape to be able to leave stuff like
well,
that.
You can test it right now. Here. Take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock, she opens. Easy.
Alright.
Oh, damn it.
He just said it. Okay. Gotcha.
See you around, Giuseppe. Se benedì.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry, you'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car.
Nice job, Joe. Good job. Oh, man.
Okay, you still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Okay, steal the Jefferson. F to lock the pick. F. There we go. Shit. Sometimes it's a little tricky because it's like right there. There we go. And. There we go.
Possible stolen vehicle.
Police want to arrest you.
Step on it.
Lose the police.
Roger that. Vehicle theft in progress. Oh, in pursuit of suspect.
Yeah, well, it's not over yet. Lose him. Quick.
10-4.
Vehicle is wanted by the police. Oh, he's shooting. Shots fired. Shots fired. Okay. Let's go as fast as we fucking possibly can. Get out of my way, fool. You're going to get hit
right.
If you get don't get out of my
way.
Like
we lost. So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. Think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a
oh,
body
shit.
Shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey, that don't sound
Move,
cheap.
Bitch.
Don't worry about it.
This guy's a maniac. We gotta take
Just
him down.
Any body shop.
Oh,
know the
fuck. They're gonna kill me. I'm really bad at driving in these games, by the way, guys. I don't know if
here.
You could tell.
Right here in front of the garage door. Okay, now honk your horn.
How do I honk my horn? There we go.
Afternoon.
Oh, man. It's been crazy. I need you to fix this
How
car up.
Help?
We had to run from the cops and everything.
The license plate.
Change the plates.
No problem.
Okay. There you go. Badass.
Give her a couple of tweaks.
Hey, you looking for a new set of wheels? Take your pick, pal.
You can paint it
any color you like. Take your pick.
I like the burgundy.
Bring it by anytime.
Yeah, now the license plate is badass.
All right, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss it.
Just smashed up the car after getting it fixed.
Who's that guy back there?
What guy?
Guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters.
What?
Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I can see myself in your pants.
Oh. Cringe.
Here, I got another one. If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
The cringe. Yeah, Tom film Vito.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
Oh, my God. And this works for you.
Oh, here's a good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, you know that?
That's actually pretty good. Oops.
How about this one? Why don't we go back to my place and play house? Give me the door and I'll slam you.
Oh,
I've heard
bad.
That one.
Hey, when you
That's
measure seven
cringe.
Soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift? All right, almost there. Make a right.
Dude,
up here.
Go. Move. Move out of my way. I'm going to go by you. Don't hit me, you stupid cop.
That's Mike's junkyard there. Just drive through the gate.
Move. I told you guys I suck. But the drivers in this game do suck. It's not just me. That's admittedly.
Hey, look who's here.
I'll tell you guys
boy,
in a second.
What's going on? Shit, Mike. You can wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bed.
Hey, I've been working. Working people occasionally get dirty, you know. Besides, I just wiped them off.
I love how he just
what?
Hits him in
the
fucking handprint now.
Used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck.
Put a lid on him. What are you from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Bruski. But don't shake his hand. I ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
Me and Vito Shakes go way anyway. Back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Uh-huh. Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car.
Oh, it's chop
take
shop.
Take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Got it.
God damn it, Mike. You put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune for this thing.
All right, calm down or I'll stick them up your ass, you sissy.
You know, dry cleaning costs these days plenty. And who knows if they can even get this filth
you
out.
You shut up. Vito, listen to me. I need a Walter coupe today. I got a few people looking for parts, but I can't find a car.
Because you don't know where to look. Every time I drive down Hunters, I see one parked by a bar there. I think the place is called the Lone Star.
Isn't that a Moulinyan neighborhood? I'll stick out like a sore thumb.
All right, look, I'll give you $350 for it. It's worth the risk, right?
Oh, Jesus Christ, there.
Deal.
Vito, come on, let's go on down.
Vito.
Meantime,
Vito's
I'll be
just
sending
chill.
You
like
the cleaning bill for my coat.
Yeah, I'll change my address, you rat prick.
Okay, listen up. This is your maiden voyage, so to speak. So try not to fuck it up, man. Here, Vito, take this, just in case.
Hey, nice. Hey, Mike, you mind if I test this thing out here?
Sure. Knock yourself out.
Alright, here we go. We're gonna learn how to shoot here.
Aim for that old wreck over there.
Alright. Shoot the tires of the wrecked red car.
Hey, you ain't a bad shot. Hey, Vito, see if you can hit the gas tank.
I leave gas in that thing?
There's a Polak choke. Leave it alone.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Fuck you.
All right, that's enough shooting. We got work to do.
Shoot you. Bang, bang. Bang, bang. This thing is so fucking smashed up. But I might as well just get back into it and drive.
Go right up here. So how's it feel
just
to
cut
be back?
Everybody off.
I feel a lot
just
better.
Don't even care.
Hey, what's the rush? Money don't buy you happiness, you know.
Get the fuck out of here.
Money does buy you other
don't
stuff.
Don't worry about the money. This little job is just to begin. Pretty soon you'll be rolling it.
So.
Whee! Ow!
No, the place actually ain't too bad now.
Oh, shit. How the hell did that happen?
All the moolies flew south for the winter. Of course it's still a shithole, Vito. You only been gone a couple of years. Gonna take a lot longer than that for that neighborhood to turn around. Them people multiply like rabbits. What are you gonna do? It's even worse than when we was kids. They even got some kind of gang there now. What's their fucking name? The Beamers, the Boomers, something like that. I don't fucking know.
No, that's just fucking great.
Hey, what are you worried about? They're animals. All they do is sell dope and kill each other. They ain't gonna bother a guy like you.
Sell dope and kill each other.
That's why I gave you that pistol.
Amazing.
Well, by the way, you're carrying a gun now? What's the deal with that?
Can't do business without it these days. Especially in this fucking neighborhood.
You, really know how to inspire confidence, you know that?
I love how cool Vito is. He's just like, you really know how to inspire confidence, you know that? Move, bitch. Alright.
It's that cream-colored baby over there. Be careful. Do it quick and get the fuck out of there. Break a window if you have to go.
Nice.
I'll wait for you back at Mike's.
Hey, what if I run into problems?
Then you deal with them. Look, consider this a test. If you fail, I hear they're hiring down at the factory.
Right, just asking.
Good luck, pal. I see you back at Mike's.
So I managed to precariously and carelessly crash the other car and destroy it. Come on, you fucker. Oh, get wrecked, Sullen.
Hey! Hey, what you doing, motherfucker?
I'm stealing your grind, dude. Later. Oh, son of a bitch. No. Alright.
Hey, mission accomplished. How'd it go?
Yeah, piece of cake. Except for the fact that the car belonged to a bunch of moolies who immediately tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Hunter's their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Pretty fucked up.
Nice. No stains. Clean. The lowlife get the money for this. Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I give you for it again?
600.
Oh, I like your buddy, Joe. Here's your 400 bucks. Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All right, boys. I'll see you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman. Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
All right, let's go home.
So he took $100. Which seems pretty fair.
We should take the highway, Vito.
Should I? Should I really?
You're right, you pulled off that job without fucking it up. Nice going.
Yeah, but I almost got my ass kicked. I didn't live through the war just to die in Sand Island.
Hey, that's all part of the deal, pal. Take it or leave it. Besides, it ain't like you're qualified for anything else.
I guess you're right.
Don't worry about it. It's all gonna be a piece of cake.
So, what's the story with Bruski?
Mike's a good guy to know. He's a little grouchy, but he's always got a scam going. He deals with stolen cars mostly. Spent some time inside a while back. I used to stick up gas stations.
In pursuit of a hit and run driver.
You gonna pay the cleaning bill for your jacket?
What the fuck? He hit me.
I do a lot of.
How the fuck?
Plus, he's got
really?
One, temper. One time he was at the track and some mitt spilled a beer on his wind ticket. Mike beat the shit out of him till he went blind in one eye. For a lousy $10. You believe that shit?
Sounds like kind of a scumbag.
Hey, you just got an out of hand for these people. And Mike's a pussycat compared to some of the guys I met since you shipped out. You'll see.
I just pushed him the fuck out of the way. Oh, man. Amazing. Ugh. Somebody sounds like they're having the deathly coughs.
If you're hungry, there's some food in the refrigerator. You hungry, Vito? Take whatever you want from the fridge.
Yeah, let's eat some fridge food. A lot of beer. Ooh, sandwich. Let's have a beer with that. Oh yeah. We're a man. Drinking beer. Crash on the kitchen couch. Okay, so that is the end of chapter 2. So, I wanted to thank you everybody so- Hold on. I wanted to thank you everybody so much for watching. As usual, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Let me know what you think about this series down in the comment section below. And if you're excited for Mafia 3, and if you want to see more, make sure to subscribe. Check out some content I create, including the annotations that I have at the end of this video. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye!